Up next for our delightful model pleasure, Revell USA's reissue 1/24th scale 1970 Pontiac Firebird. It's 8 inches long, has 83 parts in it. Doesn't sound like a lot of parts, but you're going to see there's great detail in this kit. First up, we will look at the decal sheet. Beautiful, beautiful. Full instrumentation right down to the knurled metal and the individual gauges. We've even got interior decals for the door handles, the latches, we've got center caps, we've even got the pernal indicator for the floor, and we've got two sets of stripes, beautiful faded blue and a nice white with black outline. They've even got seat belts with little tiny GM logos inside and three different Ram Air options for the hood scoop. So that is a beautiful decal sheet in this kit. Let's throw some plastic out on the table and see how we're going to be building it up. So let's get all the white plastic out. We got that beautiful nose on there, the single headlight nose. We've got our spoiler hood with nice cutout. We've got the other half of our differential there with drive shaft attached. This is a more simplified kit. If my information is correct, this is an old monogram mold, and it still holds up really nice, very crisp. Not seeing any flash that can't be removed with a quick swipe of the knife, but there is hardly any on there to begin with. The exhaust and differential are all one piece, so we'll be doing some hand painting on that. That's a nice tough looking Firebird body shell, isn't it? Nice lines on it. We got nice prominent door handle moldings. The doors themselves, the molding might need a little scribing, but it does look nice on there. We've got our side scoops with decals to go in there. We've got our underhood detail, brake master cylinder, some lines, some bottles underneath there. Nice looking rig. Great looking. Now I'm going to see when I do mine if I can't attach the nose and the tail and still get it on the chassis. So I will experiment for you guys to see if we can do it that way and get it all painted as one piece instead of having to try to attach a nose and a tail later like the manual suggests. We got some nice looking bucket seats in there, seat backs, and our air cleaner assembly, our dual snorkel Ram Air assembly. We've got our chassis here, and that looks very nicely detailed. And then we've got our interior. The door panels are prominent. And remember, we've got those decals. We don't even have to get anything out and work on those. I'm going to be doing a two-toned interior, so I will have to mask off these back seats and then paint the rest up. I think it's going to look great. We've got that really nice dashboard with all those decals included to get that painted up. We've got our 400 cubic inch V8. That's what the box says it is. Pulley system, intakes, even the carburetor on there. And there's our little hood scoop and our wheel backs. So what else is in the box? Well, we've got clear parts. We've got transparent red parts, chrome. We got options in this kit. So let's take a look at those. We've got our stock wheels, which are molded open. We've got our beautiful factory grille. We've got bumpers, exhaust tips, which are kind of drilled out. That's really nice. Put a little black in there. We've got valve covers, shifters. We've got mirror inserts, rear view mirror. On here, we've got optional set of larger wheels, more modern style wheels that you can use or save for something else. We've got our transparent red tail lights look awesome. We've got our clear parts on this one, and it is an individual glass instead of one piece, and our lights. And last, we've got, check out the beautiful Firestone wide ovals, pad printed fatties. They look really nice. If you didn't want them like that, you can do the black wall, but come on. What Firebird's not going to be cruising around in white letter tires? White lightning, baby. And then we've got the lower profile, flatter, modern tread for those larger wheels, which will look good on this kit or anything else. So I'm going to get everything in simple green. I use simple green. It's a degreaser to remove any oils, if there were any, on the plastic from molding. Then I'll do my sub-assemblies, and we will come back for a look at what I've got. So fast, and I'm back for the sub-assembly show-off. Now, this only takes about 90 minutes. There's not a lot of parts, and they go together quite well. Some things I want to discuss. We're going to be painting the wheel backs separate. Now, they tell you not to glue those in because you're supposed to be able to roll the kit around. I don't want mine rolling off a shelf, so I always glue them in tight, but you make your decision. Those wheels, will later be pushing onto the nice large stubs on the axles. And I tell you what, model makers, I love stubs like this. The little skinny ones don't do anything for me because we're completely covering it anyways. And that gives us a very solid mount that we don't have to worry about when we're building our kit and putting our final assemblies together. I love them like that. I love the studs like that. I also like metal axles. Those work really well too. What we'll be doing, the wheels need a flat coat. And then we will paint the inner centers. They weren't that a chrome like that. They were like a painted steel, according to my sources. So, and then once I put the flat coat on and do the paint, what I'll do is you can take a Q-tip with a little bit of alcohol on it and rub around the rim and bring back that bright trim ring around the outside of it so that it shines a little bit more. The thing you should know about the wheels and tires, okay? They're two-piece now. Now, a lot of times, if you were going to paint over these or redo them, you would just glue them together and go about your business and start painting and detailing. Well, on tires like this that are in the kit, that is a solid core tire inside. You see, it's not hollow. These are really hard to push over the top or the back of a rim. It's really hard to push over the bead. So you still want to assemble these in two parts and then place a little bit of what I like to use is a rubber cement inside these. When you use super glue, they will cloud, as the super glue fumes escape out the sides of the rim, they will cloud that beautiful black vinyl faster than you could say cloud the tire. Literally, they will turn it a white chalky look that does not want to come off. So that's my advice, some rubber cement, and just push the wheels in from both sides when you're done painting the wheel backs. It's going to save you a lot of headache. The grill should be all blacked out in here. This part won't be seen. This little seam between the marker lights and the turn signals and the headlights won't be seen. So instead of trying to reach in there with a black paintbrush and paint it and maintain this trim ring around the outside, I'm going to mask off each half so that all I can see is this. Then I'm going to spray it flat black. Then I can either take and scrape the black away carefully and expose my trim ring, or what I like to do is just take a Molotow pen or a silver pen and go around that borderline, and then your grill is done and it's very sharp and you have a lot less mess. That's how I prefer to do it. The rear differential is all assembled. Now we could go ahead and attach it inside. It goes on very easily without an issue, just snaps into the holes there and voila, we're done and we attach our shocks and we're all set. But the exhaust is molded in one piece with it, and I've left that little brace there so that when I'm moving it around, I don't snap anything. What I wanna do is I wanna paint this, then I wanna hand paint the exhaust off the frame so I can get in there and actually get everything painted, and then we will attach it. We'll put the shocks on, which they recommend be painted blue, so I have an opportunity to get these sprayed black and then painted blue. The radiator and the steering wheel will get sprayed black, and then their final colors before we're all done. The black I'm using for shadows. The belt, power steering, alternator assembly will all get painted black. I will pick out the back of the alternator, and then we are done with that. The 400 is a beautiful engine represented in plastic. The reason I put my hand behind it is so the camera can focus on that white. The carburetor should be tilted forward. I thought it was a little cockeyed, but that's the way it's supposed to be. Distributors back there. Our water jackets in front where our radiator hose will mount to. I left the valve covers off because instead of painting it all blue, they say that it should be blue with chrome valve covers, so that's how we will be doing it. Then I will just quickly pick out the manifolds, but I wanted to get those glued in place so that they go on easy. But otherwise, that engine takes all of 5 minutes to glue together. We've got our radiator hose that needs to be painted. We've got the bottom of our air cleaner that needs to be painted black, so that will be on there. We've got our ram air system right there. Now it's off the tree so that I can put a toothpick with some blue tack on the bottom and get the whole thing painted. We're never going to see the bottom again. Once it mounts onto the air cleaner, that's it. We're never going to see it, so it doesn't matter if it gets painted or not. Nobody's going to care. So that will be. Now, I haven't decided. My body color is going to be white. I love the look of the white car on the box, but it has a blue Ram Air, and that's obviously correct. But for a little bit of contrast, I'm still debating whether I want to make this white so that it really sticks out on that blue stripe that goes over it. So I'll decide on my own. Might not be factory perfect, and I don't care. I think it's going to look kind of tough if I do it that way, as if two guys had bought a blue one and a white one, and they knew each other, so they swapped their air cleaners so that they could really stand out on each other's cars and look pretty tough. So that's what I might be doing. That's what I'm really leaning towards. The dashboard is cut off on its own, looks awesome. Just need to get that spray painted black for the shadows, a light coat of the interior color, put our decals on, and bang, zoom, we're done. The interior tub, gonna hose it down with black so that we get all of our shadows inside. Then I will mask off certain areas and get our different floor panel and seat colors in. That'll take a little bit of masking. The seats are super easy. We will paint them black. Then I will paint them their interior color and they will be done. They will be all set because they're on their own. The body, some tips on the body. One, you're not gonna have any problems. Even though it's an older mode, everything fits really nice and you're about to see that. First, you can see it sitting on the table before I take the hood off. The hood fits on lovely, no problems. It fits even all the way around. No big gaps to be concerned about. No big, it doesn't stick up. It doesn't sit warped or anything. So we'll just slide that backwards and remove it. The body needed some assembly. The body needed the front nose, the rear valve, and the spoiler attached. It also needs the mirrors, but those will be done later. I don't want to break them off all the time when I'm working. And I've got to be able to get in here and do my chrome trim. So if I had the mirrors there, it would get in the way. As you can see, that nose has not been puttied. It has not been cut. It has been applied to the front of the car. Make sure it goes just under those lips, and that's how you'll get it to fit perfect. And you can see she goes on there with those little pins on the side to guide it in. Absolutely beautifully. No seams, no gaps, nothing. It's got that original plastic seam, which the real car is going to have to begin with, so leave it alone. But wow, some engineering on that, guys. Didn't have to spend any time cutting with an X-Acto knife, except to remove just a little bit of flash on there. The rear goes in just as nice. Check that out. We got our spoiler over the top of it. Put the rear in, you can see that it's got marks there and mold marks there. You just put it in, slide it in, bring it forward, glue it in, and you are all set and ready to go. What a humdinger that body is. Also, I said I would experiment. Can you get the chassis in? Because you have to put the suspension on. Can you get the chassis in after the clips have been put on the front and the rear? Because the manual says don't do it till final assembly. And I'm like, I don't want to mess around with super glue on my paint job and all that. It's not going to line up right. So I like to glue as much possible. Well, it is. It's easy as pie. It literally just drops in. It's not too loose. It's not too tight. You got motion to move it forward and back to line up your wheel wells, but you're going to be fine. Your interior is going to be attached to that. So when you come in, you'll just go in and gently apply your rear end first and then just slide it in, push it in, and move it to where you need to be to have it in the proper position. So yep, go ahead, put your front and rear clips on and your spoiler, you're gonna be just fine, and then you can get it all painted together. We're gonna head off into paint. I'll see you over there. All right, now that it's out of paint, everything is looking awesome. That Tamiya white just looks stunning on that body. Gives me automatic panel lines because it's so thin, and it's going to look fantastical when it's all done. I like that bright white. You can see how the hood came out. Nice strong lines on there. I don't even need to get in there and detail it. That's one thing about a nice white paint job, is that your shadows just come out all on their own. And yes, I did the scoop in white. That's the look I want to go for. I really want that to set it apart a little bit. Some things that changed, or one thing that changed since we were in the paint booth, I no longer have a two-tone interior. Why? I did the seats, the dash, the steering wheel, and the back seats and the console in that spa blue. When put up against the Oasis blue that I shot the floors and the doors with, it looked like caca. It was bad. It was such a bad contrast. It was intensely bad. Really bad. If I need to say it again, I'll say it 10 more times. So I hosed everything down with Oasis blue. So that's going to be our main interior color, blue on blue. But what I'll be doing then at this point is the dash won't need anything at all. The dash looks great as it is. I might deepen those lines a little bit on the other side of the glove box there. But otherwise, we're good to go because I just have to draw in the line for the ashtray. Yes, an ashtray with cigarette lighter probably would have been in that little flip-down area. Is apply the decals. So I'm going to black out the back of the gauges just using a Sharpie marker, just so that they're blacked out. Then I will lay the decals over when I do my dash gauges. Then I'll do the overlay of the metallic over the top. And the dash will be all done. That's ready to go as is. The carpeting and these kick panels here, I saw in a picture of a Pontiac, 70 Pontiac with a blue, that these kick panels were a little darker. They matched the carpet somewhat. You can't get them to perfect match. But those were a little darker from that level down. So I'm going to hand paint a little bit of a darker blue while leaving the center console and the rear seat and the package shelf that lighter blue. That'll give us enough of a contrast. And then I can also rub a little bit of black wash in the seats front and back, and that will give me my tonal variation. So when I'm done with the interior, we'll come back for another look. You can see that the grill is going to look great. We just got to do our chrome trim around the edges and highlight our Pontiac. Unless I look on the decal sheet again, there may very well be a Pontiac logo on there that I can use. Otherwise, I'll just have to detail that a little bit. But our air cleaner is done. Our rear suspension just needs to have the exhaust picked out, and then we will put our shocks on, which were painted blue with everything else like the manual suggests. So that'll go underneath there. Our engine is all set. I sprayed the transmission the aluminum silver they wanted. I just have to hand paint the exhaust manifolds, the oil filter, the distributor. I'm not going to paint the carburetor because once this air cleaner is on it permanently, you're not going to see anything at all. So why bother wasting 10 minutes or a few minutes painting that? It's never going to be seen. And that detail is ready to go. The belt system is ready to go, but I'll do the back of the alternator in a silver. And then the rest where the fan is on the front would have been black anyways. That's ready to mount on the front of the engine. Then we can get the engine mounted in the nice black chassis here. And then that will be ready to go. And we can put our interior in. So once I get this little bit of stuff done, I'm going to put the glass in the body, get the trim done. As always, we'll come back for another peek. This cool Firebird is another case where everything is going so easy, I have to force myself to slow down, because otherwise I'm going to get it all assembled and have a final before you guys get to see some of the detail. Check out that beautiful interior in there. That looks really nice, and I'm glad I two-toned that carpet with the interior. It just looks absolutely wonderful. Those decals slide in. What I liked about the dash decals was there was hardly any register around the gauge decals and around the dash decal. So when you put it in, there wasn't any clear area that was getting in the way. That was absolutely fantastic. They fit right in. I didn't have to do any clipping or anything. A little bit of decal solvent on those, and they just went right down inside. Same with the Perndl indicator, or the park reverse neutral drive low. I always called it Perndl, and a lot of you did as well. So the interior is all set with its decals and its paint, and that's ready to go. The steering wheel is also done. We just did a little silver paint around the edges, put our horn button in and put the Firebird logo on it, and that's ready to push in. I just wanted to wait so you guys could see how gorgeous that interior itself was. The hood, of course, is all ready to go. The air cleaner and ram air system is ready to go. The radiator just has to be pushed in before we put the body together. The radiator hose is all set, and the chassis back here. Check out those beautiful wheels. They look spectacular. Great design by Revell. We've got that 400 all done, and she's a beauty. We got our chrome valve covers, carburation, distributor. We've got our exhaust, and it all lines up beautifully underneath. You can see I just took it off and hand painted it. The only thing this needs when we're all done is I need to put the exhaust tips on. But I know darn well if I glue them on right now, when I'm snapping it into the body, I'm going to press on the back or something and pop those right off. So that's going to wait. But this is a shiny new car. So this is going to be awesome looking machine. The body itself is pretty much done. I need a second coat of white on the reservoir washer bottle there. It's over the black, so I just need one more coat and that'll be done. But I've got the master cylinder and vacuum booster all set. Under the hood is black per the pictures on the box art. The chrome trim is done on it. It's hard to see because it's a white car with the glass in it, but the glass fits in nicely. The mirror's on there. The nose is in. That looks wonderful. You can see all our detail on there. And that's a beauty. The door handles and everything will have decals coming. So will the side marker light. So instead of painting them in, I'll just wait for the decal work. We've got our tail lights in. We've got our rear bumper on. We are ready to go. These are how great it's going to look. So all I have to do now is put the interior in the body, put the body on the chassis, get my decals on, and we are done. We will see you in just a flash for the final. Revell USA's 1970 Pontiac Firebird in 1/24th scale, all done. What an awesome kit. You want to know the hardest things to do on the entire kit? Put the mirrors on. That was it. Because you got to glue them on an already painted surface, and they're small, and you got to line them up, and that was it. Even putting the chrome reflectors in the mirrors was easy. Just gluing them on, you have to be real steady, use your tweezers and some super glue, and you'll be all fine. The decals go on beautifully. As I mentioned on a lot of recent Revell issues, their larger decals are taking longer to release from the backing surface. So don't try to take them off too fast. What you want to do is get them wet, let them sit for 3 or 4 minutes, and then they will slide off beautifully, glide around the surface, and let you glue them on without any problems. These ones went on absolutely wonderful, wrinkle-free. A little bit of decal solvent, they settled right down into the creases and right down along the spoiler without showing any kind of warping or any issues. The rest of the decals enhance everything from the vents to the door handles to the key locks to the side marker lights. The beautiful screaming chicken on the nose piece. Absolutely wonderful kit. It's out now. You guys need to get it right away. I have a link in the description to get this from Model Roundup. They should have it any day now, and you'll be able to pick a copy from them for a great price. Absolutely awesome kit. Don't forget, you have the option of the bigger wheel and tire package on there. You have the other color decals, so you can customize it the way you want it. I love it with the blue interior, and that white Ram Air, I think, was the right pick for that blue stripe. I really like that. It just stands out. Going down the street, drag racing somebody, they're really going to notice that nice hood scoop on there. So, easy to build, fun to build. 2 days is all you need to put together a kit like this, and everything goes together wonderfully. Those Firestone wide ovals are gorgeous. Those factory wheels are beautiful with their little Firebird center caps. It's an absolute wonderful kit, and I highly recommend it. We will see you at the next review.